What's going on, everybody? You know what I mean? You know, we got a mukbang for you today, you know, with a little Chipotle. Chipotle! You know what I mean? Right, so let me just show you what I'm working with. Just a little bit. Hold up. Hold up. Let me take that shit off, too.
They kind of did us good today, too. There's a lot in here.
Oh, God. And then they gave me a discount for being in the military. I fuck with Chipotle. God damn, I can't get this hole open, though. They ain't want me to eat today.
Okay, I'm 47.
Okay.
How you doing?
All right. Mm-hmm. Oof.
Real cheese.
All right. So, look, man. I done did a lot in the past couple days. No cap. In the past week. Came to Oklahoma. You know what I mean? Came to Oklahoma. Been working a little bit. You know. Nothing too bad. Showing a little bit.
Crazy.
You know, it's crazy. He might get on the ox. Yeah, nothing too crazy, but, I just, it's been really progressing, and, you know, as you can see, I'm in the car. This is my car. I just bought a car this weekend, and I got tatted.
We've got no keys.
And we got tatted a little bit, some slight. But, that's pretty much all I've been doing. I've been just trying to get everything set up and everything like that. And, this is good as fuck.
It is.
That's fair. Mm-hmm. But, let me tell y'all how things went down at the dealership. Because it was a stressful situation. So, I'm over there, you know, chilling, whatever. I'm like, yo. I get there to the first dealership. I'm like, yeah, I'm looking for this car by a die. And he was like, I don't think we have that. I don't think we have that on lot. Then he ended up looking and he was like, oh, we do have it. I'm going to just pull it around. So, he pulled it around. I ended up looking at that hoe. I drove it. It was nice or whatever. But like, it had too many miles on it. And it's only been a year. And it was already 30-something thousand miles on it. I was like, hell no. So, went to his other dealership. And then, that was a 2019. So, I was like, yo, just get a new car. So like, my interest rate won't be skyrocketing, right? So I'm like, I bet. So I go to another dealership. I'm like, yo, can I get the 2020 by a die? They're like, oh yeah. It's like the starting price of it is like the normal starting price of it is like 18. So I was like, damn, that's kind of steep. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna cap to you. So I was like, I bet. So I test drove the car. I'm like, yeah, this shit is smooth as fuck. You know what I mean? Like, I can fucks with it. So, I'm driving. Dude talking to me. He like, yeah, bro. So, what you do? I'm like, yo. You know, I'm in the military type shit. I just got here like a week ago. And I'm really just trying to get a car so I can be mobile. Because being on base the whole time is whack. No cap. Like, I want to do something other than just be on the base. I'm like, yo. And my base is huge as fuck. But we're not going to talk about my base. Anyway. So I was just talking to him. He was telling me how he got, like, a girl. He got a girl or whatever by a dime. He been living in Oklahoma for a while. Been selling cars for a while. Cool dude. It's probably like, I want to say 2, maybe 3 years older than me. But it's probably like 23, 24. He was just cool. So
he was young, but he was like, he was smart. He was knowledgeable and like,
hey, yeah.
His job. I told him, I was like, you're really good at your job.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, he was really helpful, no cap. So we get over there, we start negotiating. He was like, yeah, so first negotiation, price. Since it's, he was just like, it's gonna be 15,
bro, it was like 15, 7, 30.
And I was like, all right, I mean, I could pay it. But I was like, I really want to get it down. So my ass started negotiating. I'm like, all right, so how about we cut this out, blah, blah. And then he was like, all right, bet. I could do that, right? He was like, how about 15,305? I was like, hey, okay, 15,305. And I'm like, it's still a little bit over where I'm trying to get to. He was like, damn. Well, I mean, I don't know how much I can get you down to. And he was like, and he was already throwing in an incentive for me. He was like, yeah, bro, since you're in the military, bro, I just put on a 2-year maintenance and everything for free. I was like, sheesh. And that's on, and because the car is still considered a brand new car, I already get the 3-year warranty and 5-year some other shit, right? So I'm like, sheesh. Like, you give me that shit on top of that? All right. So, I'm like, yo, really? I'm really trying to get down to, like, 14s, you know what I mean? Just because, to give me some leeway, you know what I mean? So, I'm like, I bet. I'm like, yo, hey. Like, bro, I know you can do it. Like help a nigga out type shit. He was like, bro, I don't know. Let me go talk to my people. So, he went and talked to him. Came back. He was like, all right. I got you for $14,988. I was like, that's a deal, bro. I ain't gonna cap to you. I can do that. We was in there negotiating for a good minute, like probably like an hour and a half. I was just like, bro, what the fuck? So I called my parents. You know, they trying to help me. My stepdad, he trying to help me or whatever. I'm like, yo, I understand what you're saying. Like, he was just like, bro, don't let them run your credit again. Don't let you run your credit again. I'm like, I'm not. You know what I mean? Because, one, you got so many, if you have so many inquiries on your shit, it fucks it up a little bit. So, I was just like, what's up?
I just tossed this shit all over myself.
Hello. Yeah, so I was just like, hey, yo. I was telling it. God damn. This shit got in my...
Bro, that's what I'm saying. It went, like, everywhere. What the hell?
Yeah, but,
No, it's good, though. It's all good, though.
Yeah, but... Anywho. Dude was just like, I just kept telling the guy that was about to check me out or whatever. I was like, yo, do not run my credit again. Do not do it. Right? Kept telling him that.
And what did that old ass man do?
And he was like, I'm not. I just want to get you the best rate. I'm like, bro, one dude already told me in the front, you can't beat my bank's rate, bro. And he was like, no, I'm pretty sure I can beat your rate. I'm like, no, do not run my credit. So I leave, and then I come back. And dude was like, he wasn't gonna run my credit. So when I came back, I was like, yo, so what's good? What's Gucci? And he was like, I couldn't find nothing lower. I was like, bro, didn't I tell you not to run my shit? He was like, well, I'd already ran it. Well, what the fuck you mean you already ran it? Like, what's your problem? Like, what do you mean you ran my credit? So, he was just like, it's not gonna hurt you. It's not gonna hurt you. I'm like, bro, no, bro. You gotta run that one is really, cause you like I had got hella notifications that different shits, different inquiries were on my shit, and I was like, bro, this shit's not.
This is not gonna fly.
I'm not gonna fly, bro. I'm not, bro. What the fuck?
He was just like, it's not good. It's not gonna hurt you. I'm like, I'm not gonna put you out there like that. I'm like, bro.
It took me everything to not say what I was gonna say.
Verbally assault this old man in his car dealership.
But it was just like, all right. So my stepdad, he was just like basically trying to get on my ass the whole time. And he went to talk to the bank with me. And we had asked the bank, like, yo, like, what should I have paid for a car like this, da da da. And they was like, well, he really should have paid like $1,700-$1,800 for that, because it's a brand new car. That's this and third. And he was like, he was just getting on my ass the whole time, telling me I like basically didn't know how to negotiate and shit. And then when they told him that, he was like, oh, so you got a great ass deal for it. I'm like,
yeah.
I'm like, well, yeah, because I talked him down to $14,988. Like, bro, what you mean? I feel like that was a compliment. I mean, I don't know, but I've been eating this whole time, and I haven't made a dent in this hole. It's really crazy. But yeah, so that happened, right? And right after that, me and my brother got tattoos. And what I was originally gonna get, I was gonna get the half sleeve.
I figured that, though. Like, I didn't know how long you wanted to stay there, but yeah. Basically, they told him that an image of that size and where he wanted it, it would have to be simplified.
Yeah.
Because it was really...
They were saying my shit was too detailed.
Yeah.
So,
and it they would was take, like, they it couldn't would take do hours.
Yeah, they said they couldn't do it in a day because I didn't have a... I have an appointment. So it was like, what you want? You want something smaller so we can do it quick? I like, all right, babe, I got you. So I got two tattoos or whatever. And those came out nice, no cap. It was a really cool experience. Then we went back. Then we played, we watched Pulp Fiction.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that's one of my favorite movies out there. That shit is hilarious, no cap. If y'all haven't watched it, go watch it.
Say what again?
Say what again? Anywho, yeah, that's what happened. And then we also played beer pong, but not with beer. We use Monsters. I bought a case of Monsters. Just put it in the cups or whatever and shit. But yeah, that was fun. We played Monster Pong. So that shit was cool. And then we just chilled with the guys a little bit. And then shit, nigga dozed off, no cap. I woke up and I could not find my life. I ain't gonna catch heat.
My life.
I lost it. I felt like I couldn't. I didn't know where I was. I don't know why. But I just didn't.
That's how you always feel after making like really big life decisions. You're like, what am I actually doing here?
But I was just like, bro, what? I had a dream though.
I had one of those this morning.
Yeah.
One of those life moments.
Yeah. Bro.
I was sitting there and I was like, wow, I really have $3 in my bank account and no way of getting home.
Happens. My dream was that someone had stole my car. No. Someone had wrecked my, like, crashed into my car while it was parked. Bro, I woke up and I was like, I looked outside, I was like, I was like, hell nah. I was like, damn. Yeah, but, so this is what happened in the dream. So, I was just watching a movie in the living room or whatever, chilling. And then, next thing you know, I hear, bang! I'm like, oh, shit. I'm like, I just know nobody crashed into my shit. Walk outside, my car turned over. I'm like, And then somebody, the person that hit it, right there outside the car like this. And I'm just like, I'm looking at them like,
bruh,
I know you didn't just hit a parked car. I just know. And then it's new with that. Like, day new. It's only a day old, right?
Shout out to Jake Peters.
So I'm just like, yo, bro. Like, hell nah. So they was like, really, it wasn't my fault because you wasn't supposed to be parked there. I'm like,
yo,
I was parked in a parking spot. What do you mean I wasn't supposed to be parked there? I was literally in a driveway. Like, what do you mean? But it was just like, they was really trying to make an excuse. And I was like, bro, give me your insurance, bro. Give me your insurance. And it was like, no. And I was like, what? I was like, I bet. I was like, either you go give me your insurance or you go catch these, you gonna catch the fade, bro. It was like, well, I guess we're gonna have to catch the fade. I was like, I bet. So we start scrapping. Oh. And then I hit that nigga. I ain't knock him out, but I hit him hard enough to get him on the ground. So now I'm on top. Like, yeah, bro. Pause. I'm on top like this. Hey, yeah, you don't want me to punch you again, because the next time I punch you, you're going to be lights out. You know what I mean? So he's just like, all right. It's in the glove compartment. I'm like, man, what I look like going in your car getting your shit? You go get it. Just give me your key so you can't speed off on my ass. You know what I mean? So I went and got it. Called my insurance, probably insurance people. I was like, yo, it hit my car. It was parked. It was all right, bet. And then I know this will never happen in real life, but they was like, bet, we'll just give you a Lambo. And I was like, bet. I was like, bet, shit. So.
I'll take your puny Lambo, I guess.
And then I woke up and I was like, shit, I don't got a Lambo. I still got a good ass car.
I'm disappointed.
I got a 2020 as a 19-year-old. I buy myself. Big accomplishment. First big purchase of my life.
Big life purchase.
Next purchase, a baby. No, I'm playing. Head ass.
Next stop, baby down.
No, I'm playing. But, no.
What happens if you get somebody pregnant in the military?
Should they set for life? Really?
Yeah.
The baby.
But like, do moms get like leave or whatever?
If I get a military member pregnant.
Yeah.
Yeah, they get paternity leave. And I would get it too. Not like, not as much as her, but I would get it.
Like, yeah.
Well, I didn't finish my food, but that's because
I did.
I have other things on my mind right now. I got murder on my mind. No, I'm playing. Let me chill out. Before I get somebody come and get my ass. That's been my mukbang today. A little bit. That was just a little intro into my life right now. I'll be coming out with some more of these. This is my first one that's gonna be on my channel, so you know. Y'all already know what to do. Majin Memo, like, subscribe. My Instagram gonna be down in the description and shit. I put his shit down there too. But yeah, go ahead, like, subscribe, leave a comment if you want. And you know, it's Majin Man Gang, no gang. Lit. Yes, sir.